Second night of protests here in San Diego. A couple of hundred protesters walked from the Officer Jeremy Henwood Memorial Park in City Heights through North Park.
And San Diego 6's John Carroll has been out there tonight again covering these protests. It looks like they're just now arriving back at that park. John.
You're exactly right about that, Netta. Literally, just as we're coming back to me live here, the protesters have completed their march, and they are coming back into the park right now. About the same amount of people as left, about 150, and they are coming back in still chanting their chants, and we have, as you can see, plenty of San Diego police officers standing by wearing riot helmets. They came out here about 10 or 12 minutes ago to get ready. And presumably they're going to have a rally, but while they sort of get settled and figure out what they're doing, let's show you a story that we shot tonight with the route that they took from here and back to here. Wednesday night's protest started small compared to Tuesday night, and at first the crowd here seemed to be made up primarily of young people, mainly teenagers. But as the evening went on, older people arrived and seemed to take charge of the situation. That's when the march began. With a banner listing names of people that protesters claim were killed by San Diego police, the marchers set out. West on University. But on this evening, there would be no occupying the freeway. Police vehicles lined up bumper to bumper, with lots of officers standing by in riot gear, made sure of that. And so they went on, west on University to 30th. One little girl on the sidewalk frightened by so much loud chanting, a demonstration she was far too young to understand. But marcher Bertha McNeely knew exactly why she was here.
We just want justice, you know, against the police, the cruelty the police are doing to certain people. I'm out here for justice for Michael Brown, and I'm just saying we want justice.
What do we want?
Justice!
We know we want it
now!
The approximately 150 marchers marched on, north to Adams, then east. All right, so we're back out here live, and as I was saying, the marchers just within the last minute or so arrived back here at Officer Jeremy Henwood Memorial Park, and I'm joined by one of them right now. This is Anna Davis, and she's actually live streaming on the internet right now, this whole thing, and she's been doing this tonight. So Anna, tell me, this is an effort for you to do all this. Why are you out here on this evening doing this?
Basically, one, it's to join in, you know, lifting our voices, to let the world know that, you know, our anger and of course our frustration and our rage on the injustice that was done in Ferguson.
So let me ask you about something that happened last night here and in LA, and then this morning on I-5 at Nobel. I'm sure you've heard about this. Some protesters shut down the freeway, and that really upset a lot of people. What do you think about that as far as getting your message out by shutting down freeways?
Well, personally, you know, and as well as for the collective, we actually believe in carrying out an action like that, as long as it's not over the top, you know, and we don't interfere with things like, for example, emergency vehicles, you know, rolling through that need to get to their destinations. So we believe in that, you know, and that's an act of drawing attention to, you know, the injustice and the cause of why we're marching.
Certainly did that. Now, what is going to happen now? Is it just going to be a rally at this point here in the park?
We're going to have a rally. And we are actually, we will have speakers, you know, so as we did last night.
Okay.
So, this is actually a series of demonstrations,
right,
rolled into one until the 30th.
Until the 30th, right. Yes. Saw that on Facebook. Anna Davis, thank you very much. I appreciate your time tonight. So as you heard her say, they're going to have a rally here. They're going to have some speeches. They really didn't have many speeches when they first gathered here. So obviously this will now be the time that that will happen. But just as a footnote, and I don't mean to sound not serious about this, but a man who's a security guard here at this park every single night, so he knows how things work really well here, says that the sprinklers come on around 10:30. So they're not on yet, but we're watching. If anything of note happens, we will certainly come back live to you and let you know the very latest from here in City Heights. Live in City Heights, John Carroll, San Diego 6 News.
Thank you, John.